As everybody is able to hear us,
Yes.
let's continue. Okay, so to quickly introduce about myself to all of you, hi guys, thanks for joining the session. I am Venkatraman. I am working with one of the MNCs in Hyderabad, India. I have a total of 10 years of experience to CRM, SAP CRM, of which I have done three end-to-end implementations of C4C, Cloud for Customer. Okay, so this session is basically to just give you a quick feel of C4C, introduce and showcase you the benefits of C4C, and subsequently we'll start off with the sessions and the respective topics. Okay,
Yeah.
so why are we looking into C4C is, as you all know, working on SAP background with CRM and all those other functionalities, SAP CRM has not been a successful product in the market. When I look at large enterprise or be it a small enterprise in today's generation where mobile is the most happening or most important thing, if a salesperson has to go to a customer, get an order, come back to his office and then place an order, by then there are 10 other salespeople who are approaching that customer and trying to steal those orders. And moreover, CRM has not been a very stable product. Vis-a-vis the usage of web UI, the maintenance of the application, the CRM server box by the client is pretty expensive. So coming to the sellability point, when you see that Siebel CRM has been acquired by Oracle and with Salesforce coming as a cloud solution, wherein people can work with a CRM solution on their mobile device, with any smartphone or Android phone that they can place orders, that they can connect to the SAP C4C system and do whatever they want. With this kind of a trend coming up in CRM space, SAP CRM lost its stand completely. So that is where SAP came out with a cloud solution. In CRM it is C4C and in HCM it is SuccessFactors. So what is the C4C is, I'll just show you the C4C screen. Probably we'll go in depth one by one once we start up with the sessions. This is how your C4C screen looks like. So the ease by which the end user can navigate this screen, whatever you're seeing now on the screen, is something which you can see on your mobile device also, for which you just need to have an app installed. That app is supported by Android, by Windows and by iOS. So what happens is, yes,
Venkat,
please tell me.
sorry to interrupt you. What are the
Yeah.
prerequisites for going forward with C4C?
There are no prerequisites for C4C because the C4C server is maintained by SAP. I'll tell you on that. See, the SAP has put such a landscape that the C4C, the screen that you're seeing now is called a tenant. Okay? For this tenant space, my company is paying some money to SAP. Like this, every company will be paying and reserving some space. It's just like renting an accommodation in a city.
Okay.
Okay? Now, this servers on which these tenants are hosted, SAP has kept three servers, one in the US, one in Germany, and one in Australia. So
Okay.
these servers are the servers to which these tenants will get connected indirectly through the SAP routers. Okay, so there is no prerequisite. All that the we all know that when we have to implement SAP CRM, conventionally the client has to purchase a licensed software and then he has to purchase the hardware, he has to install the servers, he has to configure the servers, all those things will be there. Right?
Yeah,
It is a
my question
heavy.
is a little bit technical.
Mm-hmm.
Saying that technically, what do you require? What are the prerequisites for you to go for C4C?
Now, technically, prerequisites means you're asking from a user standpoint or from an implementation partner standpoint.
Yeah, like for example, I should have knowledge in some kind of programming, or I should have knowledge in configs, or I should have thorough knowledge
That
on SAP.
is where this C4C product is coming. That is why I said this does not need any configuration knowledge, any programming skills, nothing is needed on this. The screen that you're seeing is built on HTML5 version. That is the UI front-end version. Okay? By mouse click, you can do any configurations or any customizations on the screen. if you want to add any complex functionality into this, then SAP will do it for you. You are not authorized to do that.
Okay.
Because the server is maintained by SAP.
Yeah.
Now similarly, if you look at our on-premise traditional implementations, what we do is we do a configuration development system, move the TR to quality, test the TR in quality and move to production, right?
Yeah.
In C4C, it doesn't happen like this. You have a test tenant given by the client, given by SAP for the client. So whatever configurations you want to do, you do it in the test tenant. The testing also happens in the test tenant only. And then through this test tenant, you raise a request to SAP asking them to create a production tenant.
Okay.
So whatever configurations that you have done on this test system or the test tenant will get copied automatically to production system, only the configuration. Please remember, not the data.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, how are you going to connect the C4C to an on-premise system? A C4C system without connecting to an on-premise is like a dead piece. Okay, so you have to connect this either to the backend CRM system or to the ECC system. Now for that connectivity, SAP has given two technologies. One is using the PIPO, that is process integration or process orchestration, and the second one is through HANA cloud integration. Now again, as I said, this C4C is completely maintained by SAP. Similarly, if you use your HANA cloud integration as the middleware platform, then over there also you would just have a tenant. HCI is maintained by SAP again. But if you use PI or PO, then that server has to be procured by the client, the hardware has to be installed and all the needed configurations have to be done, and then you set up the integration. So once you set up the integration between C4C and either CRM or ECC system, it is a seamless integration. The data flows back and forth. A customer created on C4C gets replicated to on-premise. A customer created on on-premise gets replicated to C4C also. Similarly, the sales orders and everything. Now, this C4C, what's happening is SAP is increasing its functionality every quarter. For example, in May 2015, if you look at, the sales order functionality was not there in C4C, and that got added in August 2015. In November 2015, sales contracts feature got added up. So every quarter, SAP is increasing or enhancing the functionality that it is offering to its end customers through C4C. So how is this enhancements coming into our tenant? These enhancements, the SAP will put it on their central servers across those three locations, and every tenant that is hosted on that server gets updated automatically.
Why do you need CRM backend then?
How would you process your eventual, you know, the billing or the, if you suppose a sales order is created in C4C, what is the next activity for that? You need to have the invoice, you need to have the logistics, you need to have the delivery note created, right?
Yeah.
Those features, as C4C is purely a CRM box, just a CRM box. It cannot even do billing. It can do only pricing part. Okay. So if a sales order or a service ticket or a campaign is to be executed in C4C, for a campaign I need funds. Now where do I get the funds into C4C? I need to integrate it either to on-premise ERP or to CRM system.
Yeah.
Is it clear?
Yeah.
Now the screen that you're seeing on the front now is the HTML version of C4C. C4C is coming in two versions. One is HTML version and one is Silverlight version. The one that you're seeing is in HTML version with this light blue color in the background. A Silverlight version is exclusively meant for administrators. You can navigate to Adapt and click on Launch in Microsoft Silverlight. So this will open up the Silverlight client. I'm just showing that so you can get a look and feel of that. Just a second.
Venkat, do you have any contents like thing? These are the things which you are going to provide in C4C, and these are this the chapters which I am going to cover, something like that, which will give us some idea what things are you going to cover in your sessions.
Yeah, I'll show the contents. Just a second. So for these are the topics that we'll cover: C4C architecture, how do you do the project scoping, the questionnaire and the implementation strategy, then what do you mean fine-tune activities, then org management and territory management, activity management, leads, opportunities, quotations, sales orders, marketing, service, then C4C UI configuration, then integration with HCI, with ECC through HCI. What do you mean by code list mapping, email and mobile integration, and then finally data downloads. So this would be covered in a span of 18 days with 1 hour per day, and these are topics that we will speak.
So this will cover even configurations each and every bit by bit on C4C?
Topic number 12 speaks on configuration. Topic number 3, 4, every topic speaks about configuration. And to show you the Silverlight client, I'll just log in. If you can see the difference, this is a Silverlight client and this is your HTML client. Any questions so far?
So you mean the C4C cannot be implemented standalone?
No, it has to get integrated to an on-premise system.
And most probably that on-premise system would be ERP.
It has to be an ERP, yes. It could be either ECC or CRM, either of the two.
But since you said C4C cannot do billing on its own, delivery on its own, and even the backend CRM that cannot offer such functionality.
I had an implementation scenario, a sales order created in C4C gets replicated to CRM system. From CRM system, it gets replicated to ECC through standard middleware, and from ECC, it takes the further processing, delivery note and all. It could be a scenario that you integrate C4C directly to ECC if you don't need any data to be maintained in ECC CRM system. It depends on the business processes that the client wants to implement and the system landscape defined by the architect.
So the basic need by the client will go for C4C. You mean to say something which will have some good features on the front end type, where it will, for the Salesforce people to go to field and then do the ordering system then and there and then update that.
If you would have seen the Salesforce.com screen, the SFDC screen, mm-hmm. It is such a easy user navigable screen that the end users can navigate at very ease without any problems or complications. Now, compared to that, if SAP CRM screen is checked, the web UI, it has so many work centers or anything, so many of the navigation panes and all, that if a user wants to add a particular field, then there's a very tedious process involved into it. But when you look at the C4C screen, adding a new button or a new text field is a matter of 5 minutes. And for that, the users do not have to depend on SAP experts. The end user administrators would be trained by the implementation partners in such a way that they can take care of the C4C application. If there's any major challenging need by the client, then they have to go to SAP. Please remember that once the
so C4C... What is our role basically, when, for example, when we have been appointed as a C4C consultant, what is our role basically?
You are an implementation partner. Now, for example, I am a completely end customer. I don't know ABC of SAP. Okay. I am running a company wherein I want to sell my goods, my products. I approach you as an implementation partner and I say that this is my requirements. I want the opportunity screen, the quotation, the sales order and its pricing in the SAP system. So you would implement the C4C for my requirements and integrate my system to C4C to ECC system, and then your job is over. Now, this application would further be maintained by me and by SAP only. You would not be involved into any support because C4C support is not given to any vendor as of now by SAP.
This is me. Venkat?
Yes.
Yeah, this is Gopal. I'm calling from US. See, in case of any custom requirement, as you said, we have to take help of SAP, right? So, is SAP is
no, Gopal. If it is
in case of a customization, any custom requirement, C4C application all the time.
Say, for example, in a sales order screen, the customer wants some new fields. The customer wants a text field or a drop down or something like that. Then when we do the implementation and when we are handing over the application to the client, we would train the set of end customers who would be working as administrators. So we give them the training on how to do this basic maintenance in terms of some adding new fields or creating a new business role, or you know, assigning users to a particular business role, or moving the buttons from one location to other location. All these basic configuration skills, we as an implementation partner would train to the end customers administrators. Over and beyond this, if the client needs some major functional changes after we have done with the implementation, then they have to go to SAP because SAP maintains the support.
No, I'm asking during the implementation. Say, for example, I want to set up a specific email notifications when sales order is created, and I wanted to route it through different channels. So that is not, which is cannot be done through the minimum configuration or any personalization on the system. So it might require some custom development. If that is the case, again, we have to depend on the SAP, right?
Yes, because the
we can able to in that regard.
No, I'll tell you. As of now, SAP recommends only the best practices to be implemented because this is a public tenant. The tenants that SAP is giving to the end clients are public tenants. Now, if you want some custom development to happen, say for example, you want HTML5 development, UI development for your particular requirements, then your client you as an implementation partner should recommend to your client that you should go for a private tenant. And in such private tenants, you can do coding changes. The way we do custom developments like baddies or something in on-premise systems, you can do development if it is a private tenant but not a public tenant.
Fine. Why I'm
If you
asking?
see the screen URL, I have just highlighted a word. As you can see, this tenant is a public tenant. Means this tenant space is not only used by my company, but it is being used by other set of companies as well. So if you do any coding development on the screen, it will impact those other tenants as well.
Okay, so how the in ROI point of view, in how I mean maintenance cost, as there are so many CRM tenant systems and CRM applications are available, right?
Right.
Their maintenance cost very less comparatively in SAP.
SAP challenges that compared to on-premise implementation. Yeah, I'm coming there. SAP challenges that compared to on-premise implementation, a C4C implementation would get a 700% benefit, 700% benefit to the client. How is it happening is, the first of all for C4C, the client does not have to purchase any hardware. He does not have to purchase any hardware softwares. All that he needs is just the license for n number of users. Right?
Yes. Yeah, that
now
is understandable. In the cloud computing, it's a, all CRM applications are designed like that. So they don't have to implement any hardware, any software requirement, not
exactly.
Only in C4C. The question is here, say for example, I have attended SFDC training in demo.
Okay.
I understand they have their own development programming developers.
Okay.
And in case of any custom development, they can do themselves some custom development with minimum efforts. So SFDC has provided 80% of the application support for to meet all client requirements. So here the question is, the whatever the features in cloud, it is applicable for all other cloud technologies offered by different companies like MS Azure and Amazon and SFDC and other CRM applications which are coming in the market like IBM's BlueMax. So
yes,
the important thing is that in CRM market, SFDC is, of course, we have to agree that SFDC at present it's a brand leader, number one. Okay, so because of the maintenance cost, the clients are very much happy with maintaining of the CRM application, and they are satisfied with the SFDC and other cloud computing applications.
Right.
SAP realized after a long time, and now they have started coming into the market, and it is making a lot of confusion in the market. See, you have a S4 HANA, HANA is there, and on-premises HANA,
right.
And again C4C, and again here dependencies are more in C4C application, in case if I want to go in C4C. I do not know whether it can meet all other channels requirement like sales cloud, service cloud, marketing cloud, and finance. So the confusion is going on over here. And again, in case if I want to do some any custom development, again I have to depend on the SAP, for which I have to pay again some amount.
Gopal, the point is, SAP's this product C4C is a very niche baby in the market. It is evolving further and further every quarter. So before the product is fully evolved like a traditional on-premise ECC or a CRM system, if the end users start doing their own developments into the public tenant, this is going to impact every other tenant, as I said. Now, when you compare a Salesforce.com SFDC product and a C4C product, conventionally C4C is primarily you know, taken by those customers who already have an ERP as SAP. Okay, if a client is not having any ERP in place and at this point in time he's thinking of taking SAP, then yes, the question will arise for him as to why should I choose C4C when Salesforce.com is doing a better job for customers as their ERP. The best integration via C4C. And at the point of your confusion whether development should be done
Venkat, your voice is breaking.
Then you raise it SAP. SAP
Venkat, your voice is breaking. I cannot hear anything.
I am not sure if others are able to hear me.
Yeah, it's it seems to it's good. Your voice is better.
Okay, so what I was saying is C4C, if you have any functionality which you see that you need it and C4C is not offering it as of now, then you raise it to SAP. SAP will tell you a roadmap as to when that functionality will be included in C4C. But they do not give the rights of doing custom development on C4C. That is a product limitation. SAP's design is like that.
So that is the main question he's here, Venkat. See, I'm a SAP CRM consultant. The past 11 years I'm working in CRM products. I'm more interested in C4C. I have big questions. Being an SAP CRM consultant, so the technically we should have some basic knowledge and some basic kind of coding knowledge and other stuff. See, the question is here, see, we go for the custom. See, client obviously coming with a different new functionalities. Sometimes it required to go with some custom development. So here the point is the maintenance cost. So that is the, again you have to depend on other on either an SAP or any other tenant systems or tenant.
Gopal, I'm sorry, but I just do not understand what maintenance cost is there in C4C. The client has to just pay the tenant space for n number of users. And any development that is needed has to be done by SAP and for which they do not charge any amount.
Oh, okay, that is what I'm expected actually. So that's fine.
That's what I'm saying. When the tenant is maintained by SAP and if you want any functionality, they do it at their service. It is not chargeable again.
Okay, got it. I understood.
So I think this short demo is fine to get a glimpse of what is C4C all about, and probably you can put forth your questions or recommendations or anything to Sana, and accordingly we can see how this goes forward. Fair enough.
Venkat, only one question. You will be covering all in 18 days.
Yes, the topics that I have shown here are the ones that we are going to cover in 18 days. Yes.
One day, 1 hour per day.
Yes.
And what would be the timing?
Preferably it is like this night 10 to 11 because there are people from across the geographies, from some from US, UK, India, everywhere.
No problem. Night timing is not a problem for me.
Right.
That only concern is whether we will be able to complete within 18 days.
See, I am going to show you the scenarios. I am going to show you what all can be configured. Okay? And then I am also going to share a tenant with the user credentials. You can practice offline, apart from the training sessions, you can also practice. And these topics will be covered in 18 days. That's how I have been doing for quite some time.